is Dominic. Dominic works at a five-star restaurant called The Pixel Palace. There, some of video games' most popular celebrities pop in to have a drink. Sometimes they share stories and even secrets. Because as we all know, what the bartender hears is confidential, isn't it?
So I'm sitting there tending bar when in walks someone I see quite often around the place, Pac-Man. Now Pac-Man is usually a very quiet bloke, and this time was no exception. He doesn't make much chit-chat, so I just left him to his drink. And then all of a sudden, Link came up. And I'm thinking to myself, oh no, this can't be good. Anything involving this guy can never be good. But he sits down next to Pac-Man, and they start chatting. This is interesting. And at one point, Link starts holding Pac-Man's hand. And Pac-Man doesn't seem to mind. In fact, he's sort of into it. Now, usually I don't mind, I don't question this kind of stuff, none of my business, but I knew that Pac-Man was a married Pac. I mean, I immediately start thinking about Mrs. Pac-Man and how, you know, she wouldn't approve of any of this, so decide to butt my nose in, you know, not really my place, but I felt I should say something. I said, "Oi, Mr. Pac-Man, does your wife know about this?" And he says, "Well, me and my wife, we got an understanding." And then Link says, "Oh yeah, me and my wife, we got an understanding too." And I said, "Are you sure? I mean, that really doesn't sound like her." And he says, "No, we got total understanding. In fact, she's in the back. You want me to go get her?" And I said, "Well, I wouldn't mind saying hello to the missus." So he leaves the room for a second. I'm left there with Link. He's doing all sorts of under the green skirt jokes I didn't even know existed. He has like 30 of those jokes. I'm just amazed at that. And then finally, Mrs. Pac-Man returns. And sure enough, there she is, sitting down, chatting with Link, and I just said, "Oi, I just want to check. You know that your husband is seeing Link right now?" She says, "Oh yeah, yeah, me and the husband, we got an understanding." And I said, "Yeah, that's what your husband said too." And she says, "I know it's a little taboo, but you know, it's just the way the Pacs like to swing things." I'll say, "Okay, I guess that's no big problem then." And then all of a sudden, Cupid pops up. He says, "Oi, Mrs. Man, I haven't seen you in forever. We still gonna go out Thursday night?" And I thought to myself, well, if she's seeing other people, can't be much of a problem. But she seemed a little hesitant, kind of wanted to get away from Cupid there. She just kind of quickly nodded and then rushed out of the place very quickly. I thought that was rather odd that she rushed out so quickly, and Link sort of thought so too. But just before we could even think about it, Pac-Man came back in. He said, "Was my wife here?" We said, "Yeah." He said, "She straightened everything out?" And I said, "Yeah, yeah, and everything's straightened out." And Cuba comes up to Pac-Man and he says, "Oi, you've got the world's coolest wife, you know that?" And he says, "Oh no, oh no." And he says, "Actually, I'm gonna give her a call right now if that's not, you know, too inappropriate." Pac-Man looks left and right and says, "Actually, that wouldn't be very appropriate." Cuba says, "Why?" "Well, she's on her way to the car right now, and she always turns off her phone every time she's on her way to the car, so it probably won't be on anyway." Cuba says, "Oh, it's a shame. Want to tell her to bring the extra strength glowing pellets that make your hoo-ha turn blue." And he says, "You know what, maybe she is out there. Let me go get her real quick." Well, immediately Link and I start looking at each other like, this is a little strange. Pac-Man and Mrs. Pac-Man are never in the same room, are they? Within a few seconds, Mrs. Pac-Man comes back, and lo and behold, there's no Mr. Pac-Man with her. She flirts with Cupid a little bit and gives him a pat on what I pray to God is behind. And I hear Cupid distinctly whisper into her ear, "Maybe tonight's the night I'll finally get some." And she just smiles and pinches his... Well, I know it wasn't his cheek, but I digress. Cupid leaves the room, and now Mrs. Man is stuck with us again. Well, Link and I are giving her this look, and I'll say, "Oi, where's your husband right now?" She said, "In the bathroom." I said, "Yeah, where were you just a few minutes ago?" She said, "The parking lot." Link says, "I never see any pictures of you two together." She says, "I'm camera shy." "Where's your wedding ring?" "I lost it." "You didn't get another one?" "Didn't need it." I said, "What's your maiden name?" She said, "Woman. Pac-Woman." I said, "You're Pac-Man, aren't you?" And she said, no, I don't know what you're talking about." I said, "Game's up, Mr. P, we know it's you." Takes off the bow, wipes off the lipstick. It was Mr. P was Pac-Man and Mrs. Pac-Man. And I just realized, I'm in the crying video game. Crying game music, because that was about man and woman. You're gonna get it later, you're gonna laugh. So I of course ask, "Oi, why are you doing this?" And Face says, well, have you ever wondered what it's like to be two people? Mink says, no, but my wife certainly has. He says, it's very liberating to be any gender you want, have any gender you want, any time you want. And I said, all right, that's all dandy and good, but, just what gender are you anyway? Mink said, it better be a fucking man. He said, the truth of the matter is the packs don't have a gender. In fact, we don't even have private parts. There's all like Ken dolls down there. Which Link suddenly says, well, wait a minute, how did we ace as the Strap-Ons? He gets them at a specially made Mr. Potato Head's shop. Just strap it on, take it off. I suddenly realize why I'm supposed to mind my own business. But Pac-Man assured Link, he said, oi, I'll still find you attractive. I still think you're incredibly handsome. And I think I even have feelings for you. So come on, can't we patch this up? Link said, sorry, you lost me and I had feelings for you. He said, the attractiveness and the handsomeness, I could go along with them, but the feelings, that's just too clingy for me. Link is such a prick. He tells Pac-Man, he says, I'm gonna go find Cupid and hook up and tell him the truth. You're on your own, Lemonhead. And Pac-Man says, wait, what about our Triforce of Love? Link says, it's gonna be a duplex of disappointment. Which I guess logically sort of makes more sense. After all, I bet Cupid does get the better BJ with that mouth and all, but I seriously digress. So Pac-Man is sitting there, tears in his eyes, and I say, oi, it's okay, there's plenty of other corn puffs in the cereal bowl. And Pac-Man said, I know, but I guess in the end, I still have the ghosts. I say, you and the ghosts are seeing each other? He says, of course we are. Haven't you played the game? I chase him around and then I eat him out. I say, here's your bill. You see a lot of strange things as a bartender. See a lot of strange things at the Pixel Palace. So, I see a lot of strange things as a bartender at the Pixel Palace. That ain't no lie. So wait a minute.